when I was like 17 years old, I worked at a gas station overnights, a BP overnight, like overnight shift, graveyard shift at a BP. Oh my God, the stories that I could tell about just my 6 months at the BP.
Overnight.
A friend of mine that was working there, right? Who's been in other stories, but obviously I'm not going to give the name away. He worked one of the overnight, he would work the other overnight shift. Like I would work four and then he would work three and then we would flip flop. And it was a rather interesting time to be at a gas station. You can imagine, right? And in Georgia, at the time, they didn't sell booze on Sundays. So you could make an extra $60 just selling people booze on Sundays out the back door. I mean, you'd ring it up, but you'd ring it up as like a, you know, six pack of Coke for $30 and they were taking a suitcase out the back door. And then they give you $20 for selling it to them, right?
Yeah.
It was a whole thing and just smoking pot in the back. It was a tiny little gas station too. It was like one of those little small little gas stations.
Right.
Not the big QT type things, but
yeah,
you know, 500 square feet. So one night, I was going to tell you about one of the guys that worked there with me. He overnight, he went a little bit nutty and he just started scratching off lotto tickets, but he didn't have the money to pay for them. But he got like five lotto tickets in and he won like $250.
Oh, wow. Well, then he had the money to pay for them.
That's right. After he scratched off an additional like $6,000 worth of tickets because he thought he was going to win. He's like in his mathematical.
The gambler that's mentality. Right.
In his head, mathematically, this was all going to work out if he could just get enough tickets.
Yeah.
It was a big ordeal. You know what they did? They moved him to another location. They didn't even fire the guy.
Wow.
That's how badly they needed help at the VP in the middle of the night.
Sure.
They moved him to a bigger gas station, a better gas station with more lotto tickets. Who knew? So I'm working the graveyard shift and about 3:30 in the morning, a car full of women pull up. And sometimes we would lock the doors and sometimes we wouldn't. It just really depended on, you know, you were supposed to, but you didn't because it was, you know, it was a different time and a different place. And it was in a rather suburban area. So the girls kept
trying. 1800s. Yeah.
1822.
Oh, horse and carriage pulled up.
That's right. I used to work at British Petroleum. It wasn't a gas station. It was an actual well. I'd be there pumping the oil. I'd stick it through a little filter, and then we had torches. We'd dip it in the oil, and we'd light it up, and we'd say, hey.
We got oil.
0.77 shillings per gallon. Come on in. President Dwight D. Rockefeller. Dwight D. Rockefeller. President Andrew Amos. The sixth president of these United States, Andrew Amos. Forgotten. Little known president there, Chrissy Hoadley.